Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel Double A Lectures. I am Dr. Saurav Mani Tripathi and the topic of this short lecture is Direct Current Machines, Parallel Paths. Many times we hear about the term parallel path, but always remain unable to understand what basically it is. This concept can be understood by means of an illustration. So have a look. Let us first consider a 4-pole DC machine. For the sake of simplified illustration, we have also considered 4 coils as shown on the screen. These coils are to be placed in the slots of the armature core with some specific arrangements. The 4 black dots are representing the 4 brush positions of the DC machine. Now see what happens when the armature coils are arranged in such a manner as illustrated now on your screen. In order to easily understand this sort of armature coil arrangement in the DC machine, the armature circuitry has been rearranged on the right side, wherein you may verify that the coil ends AA double B and CC double D are connected to the positive brush terminal. On the other hand, the coil ends AD and BC are connected to the negative brush terminals. Clearly, you may observe that there are 4 parallel paths for the flow of armature current. At this moment, it is worth remarkable that this sort of armature coil arrangement is identical to that of lap winding. Also notice that this is the case of 4-pole DC machine and there are 4 parallel paths. So, in lap winding case, we may state that the number of parallel paths is always equal to the number of machine poles and total armature current is equally divided among parallel paths. Obviously, for this reason, the lap wound armatures are generally used in large DC machines having high current and low voltage ratings. Also note that for lap winding case, the number of brushes is also equal to the number of machine poles. Now see what happens when the armature coils are arranged in a different manner. However, before making another arrangement of armature coil, let us first remove the connections between AD, BC, AA double B and CC double D as illustrated in this figure. After this, the coil ends are connected in such a manner as illustrated on your screen now. The armature circuitry has been rearranged on the right side, wherein you may verify that the coil end AA is connected to the coil end D and the coil end CC is connected to coil end B. Moreover, the coil ends BB, DD are connected to the positive brush terminal. On the other hand, the coil terminals AC are connected to the negative brush terminal. Clearly, one may observe that there are only 2 parallel paths for the flow of armature current. At this moment, it is worth remarkable that this sort of armature coil arrangement is identical to that of wave winding. Notice that this is the case of 4-pole DC machine and there are only 2 parallel paths. So, in wave winding case, we may state that the number of parallel path is always 2 irrespective of the number of machine poles and each path carry half of the total armature current. Obviously, for this reason, the wave wound armatures are generally used in such DC machines having low current and high voltage ratings. It is also notable that for wave winding case, there may be 2 or more brush positions. So, this is all about the concept of parallel paths. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.